Well, good morning and welcome to our daily devotions here. Pastor Mark coming to you this Monday to help you get your week started. You know, over the past weekend, I've just as a pastor had an opportunity to walk beside many people who are going through suffering right now. And I realize, in some sense, this pandemic world and quarantining, or at least social distancing and masks, is starting to feel routine, at least, and that sense of normal. And yet there's still so many people sick, there's still people dying. Economically, there's still people who are struggling really hard. Got to walk with a number of people in each of those, or those types of situations of trials. So I just want to talk a little bit about suffering this morning. It's on my mind. And when you think about suffering, I mean the epitome of suffering, or maybe it's the pit of suffering, is Job. And so in Job chapter 7, verses 5 or 6 through 9, Job chapter 7, "For hardship does not spring from the soil, nor does trouble sprout from the ground. Yet man is born to trouble, as surely as sparks fly upward." And this is some advice his friends give Job, who is beginning to suffer. "But if I were you, I would appeal to God. I would lay my cause before him. He performs wonders that cannot be fathomed, miracles that cannot be counted." Job was a faithful believer. We know that. He believed in God. He followed God's word. And yet he still had a great satisfaction in the worldly things, good worldly things. His family, a large family. He had many possessions he'd worked very hard for. And that gave him great satisfaction in life. Many people that I know. But God allowed Satan to take it all away from him. And Satan attacked Job so hard that he left him in a state of physical and spiritual anguish. Now, I guess the good news is that the odds are, at least, that we'll probably never suffer the way Job did. Still, we can certainly feel like our world is collapsing all around us. We can suffer through difficulties without a glimmer of happiness in sight. And we may even think to ourselves, "I work so hard, and this is all the gratitude I get from people around me?" Or maybe you ask, "Why can't people at school appreciate me for who I am?" Or maybe we think, "Can I ever be really happy with my life?" The devil can take advantage of our most subtle doubts, and he can even make us wonder, "Does God really care about me?" Listen, as your pastor, as your friend, don't let Satan steal your confidence in who you are. Remember that you are God's own child for whom he died. God loves you. He is the strength of life. He will provide exactly what you need, exactly when you need it. And because of Jesus, your identity is secure with God. Let me pray for you. Dear Lord, strengthen us to face our trials with confidence in your wisdom and love. And thank you for making us your children through Jesus. Amen. God bless you. God grant you his peace and his strength this week. We'll see you next time.